Good day, everyone. Today, we will start by getting a brief understanding of the working of a drone. The objective of this lecture is to give you a basic idea of how a drone works, how does it take off or land, how does it turn, and how does it move forward and sideways. By the end of this lecture, you will get a basic idea of the working of a drone. For the current lecture, we will be understanding the basics of a drone a quadcopter configuration, since most of the times the quad configuration will be used. Now let's see the basic working of the drone. Drones are a headline making piece of technology capable of capturing incredible video in the hands of skilled pilots and providing some serious internet entertainment when a dog mistakes one for a frisbee. We have had instances on campus when an eagle attacked a drone, thinking it to be a threat, and damaged one of its propellers. We have watched drones perform record-breaking Super Bowl light shows and looked on as they provide media coverage and relief assistance in the wake of devastating hurricanes. Besides is a video which shows how Intel used us form of drones for performing various configurations during its 50th anniversary. It is amazing to see how something so wonderful is done. Learning to fly a quadcopter has its own perils. Everyone goes through a different struggles when piloting a quadcopter for the first time. Multi-rotor flying definitely has a learning curve, but does a drone actually fly? Let's look at the details of the flight. Now, a drone can do three things in the vertical plane: hover, climb, or descent. To hover, the net thrust of the four rotors pushing the drone up must be equal to the gravitational force pulling it down. So what about moving up, which pilots call climbing? Just increase the thrust of the four rotors so that there is a non-zero upward force that is greater than the weight. After that, you could decrease the thrust a little bit, but there are now three forces on the drone: weight, thrust, and air drag. So you will still need for the thrusters to be greater than for just a hover. Descending requires doing the exact opposite. Simply decrease the rotor thrust speed so the net force is downwards. Drones use rotors for propulsion and control. You can think of a rotor as a fan, because they work pretty much the same. Spinning blades push air down. Of course, all forces come in pairs, which means that as the rotor pushes down on the air pushes up on the rotor. This is the basic idea behind lift, which comes down to controlling the upward and downward force. The faster the rotor spins, the greater the lift, and vice versa. Next, let's talk how you can rotate the drone. Let's say you have a hovering drone pointed north and you want to rotate it face east. How do you accomplish this? By changing the power to the four rotors. Before answering, I will draw a diagram of the rotors viewed from above, labeled 1 through 4. In this configuration, the red rotors are rotating counterclockwise and the green ones are rotating clockwise. With the two sets of rotors rotating in opposite directions, the total angular momentum is zero. Angular momentum is a lot like linear momentum, and you calculate it by multiplying the angular velocity by the moment of inertia. Wait, what is the moment of inertia? It is similar to the mass, except it deals with rotation. Yes, it gets rather complicated. But all you need to know is that the angular momentum depends on how fast the rotors spin. We will be looking more about this when we talk about the details of the forces and moments of the drone. If there is no torque on the system here being the drone, then the total angular momentum just remains constant, zero in this case. Just to make things easier to understand, I will say the red counterclockwise rotors have a positive angular momentum and the green clockwise rotors have a negative angular momentum. I will assign each rotor a value of +2, +2, -2, -2, which adds up to 0. I left off the units. Let's say you want to rotate the drone to the right. Suppose I decrease the angular velocity of rotor 1 such that now it has an angular momentum of -1 instead of -2. If nothing else happened, the total angular momentum of the drone would now be +1. Of course, that can't happen. The drone rotates clockwise so that the body of the drone has the angular momentum of -1. Boom, rotation. But wait, decreasing the spin of rotor 1 did indeed cause the drone to rotate, but it also decreased the thrust from rotor 1. Now the net upward force does not equal the gravitational force and the drone descends. Worse, the thrust forces aren't balanced, so the drone tips downward in the direction of rotor 1. To rotate the drone without creating all those other problems, decrease the spin of rotor 1 and 3 and increase the spin for rotors 2 and 4. The angular momentum of the rotors still doesn't add up to 0, so the drone body must rotate. But the total force remains equal to the gravitational force and the drone continues to hover. Since the lower thrust rotors are diagonally opposite from each other, the drone can still stay balanced. Now, what would you do if you want to rotate the drone left? Think about it very carefully so that you can exactly understand the turning of the drone. The figure shows the basic forces on the drone, basically drag and thrust. What is the difference between moving forward or backward? None, because the drone is symmetrical. The same holds true for side-to-side motion. Basically, a quadcopter drone is like a car where every side is the front. This means that explaining how to move forward also explains you how to move backward or on either side. In order to fly forward, I need a forward component of thrust from the rotors. Here is a side view with forces of a drone moving at a constant speed. How do you get the drone into this position? You could increase the rotation speed of rotors 3 and 4, the rear ones, and decrease the rate of rotors 1 and 2. The total thrust force will remain equal to the weight so that the drone will stay at the same vertical level. Also, since one of the rear rotors is spinning counterclockwise and the other clockwise, the increased rotation of those rotors will still produce a zero angular momentum. The same holds true for the front rotors, and so the drone does not rotate. However, the greater force in the back of the drone means it will tilt forward. Now, a slight increase in thrust for all the rotors will produce a net thrust force that is a component to balance the weight along with the forward motion component. Hence, this is how the drone will start moving in the forward direction. The above lecture talks about the basic working of a drone in terms of going up or down, turning or going forward or backward. Students are requested to get these concepts very carefully as they would be using this during the entire part of the course. As we move further in our course, these concepts will get refined further and further to understand them thoroughly and use them while designing a drone and flying a drone. Thank you very much.